I want you to measure your degree of breathlessness, and we're going to talk about that. You're sitting down long enough. I know you've done the nose and blocking exercise, but you've recovered. It's been a few minutes since you've done it. We have a breath hold time during rest, and we have a breath hold time during physical exercise. What you've just seen Jess and Ellis do is the breath hold time during physical exercise. So there's two breath hold times. Now, why are we interested in your breath hold time? Breath hold time is a very good measurement of breathing pattern disorders. Very good. Because there's a correlation between your breath hold time, your respiratory rate, your breath hold time, whether your upper chest or diaphragmatic breathing. So it looks at the biochemical, it looks at your breath hold time relevance to CO2. Biochemical, biomechanical, are you upper chest breathing? And also psychological. So breath hold time is the most simplest and easiest way to give you a quick feedback on how your breathing is. By the way, don't worry what you get. It's only for your own feedback. So you take a normal breath into your nose, a normal breath out through your nose, you pinch your nose with your fingers, and you hold your breath until you feel the first definite reaction of your body to take a breath. And then you let go and breathe, but your breath at the end should be fairly normal. I'm going to put up a clock on this. So the instruction again is, you don't alter your breathing prior to the breath hold. You take a normal breath into your nose, a normal breath out through your nose, you pinch your nose with your fingers, and you time it in seconds. How long does it take until you feel the first definite reaction to breathe? And that's your bolt. So it's a normal breath in, normal breath out, pinch your nose, hold your nose, relax into your body, and time it in seconds. How long does it take until you feel the first definite reaction to breathe? Your breath at the end should be fairly calm. Now, always when you do it, is always relax into the body. So if you hear your breathing at the end, you probably just pushed it a small little bit. So as a measurement, just be conscious of that. Okay, so you've measured your bolt scores. So what does it measure? Your bolt score measures your relative breathing pattern during rest. The lower your bolt score, the harder you breathe. The more likely you are to breathe upper chest, the more likely you are to have chronic hyperventilation syndrome with lower end tidal CO2, the more likely you are to have increased amounts of breathlessness. So this is a really good measurement of two forms of breathlessness. One is the onset of breathlessness. How soon do you get breathless with physical exercise? The second test is your endurance of breathlessness. How breathless are you across a given level of physical exercise? So your bolt score measures breathlessness, measures dyspnea. Now, an athlete should have a bolt score of 40 seconds. 40 seconds. So there's two breath hold times. A 40 second breath hold time for an athlete is absolutely the goal. You've got the upper limit, so this is the pace is walked. This is the maximum, what Jess and Ellis did. The maximum number of paces that you can walk measures the upper limit of tolerance of breathlessness. And your bolt measures your onset and endurance of breathlessness. But there is a correlation. The harder you breathe, the lower your bolt score, the more you use your upper chest, the lower your bolt score, the lower your spirometry readings, FEV and FEC, is related to a low Bolt score. People with panic attack and anxiety, they have a low Bolt score. People with panic attack, a very low Bolt score. So it's a good measurement of stress in an individual. So it's quite a useful indicator. You don't need any equipment. You could line up your team of athletes, measure one Bolt after the other, after the other, after the other. The athletes with poorer breathing patterns will have a lower Bolt.